Good afternoon. It is a great pleasure for me to be here today. We are grateful to the Agence Française de Développement for launching this initiative last year, and to Cassa Depositi e Prestiti and IFAD for co-hosting this second edition. Let me also thank all the participants for actively engaging in the proceedings. The agenda of these 2 days has been very rich, ranging from agriculture to green growth, from private to social investment. These are also critical dimensions to build a solid and sustainable recovery. As G20 presidency, we shaped our agenda around 3 pillars: people, planet, and prosperity, striving to promote the development of new paradigm to enable a robust and sustainable long-term global recovery. Finance ministers and central bank governors met for the 4th and last time on October 13th in Washington, D.C. in the run-up to the G20 Leaders Summit to be held on 31st October in Rome. As we approach the end of our presidency, let me briefly recall some of the main achievements. Supporting low-income, small and vulnerable countries, which have suffered very much from the consequences of the global downturn, has been high on the Italian presidency agenda. The G20 was instrumental to reach an agreement on new allocation of special drawing rights, equivalent to $650 billion, the largest in the history of the International Monetary Fund. We recently agreed on options for channeling SDRs toward the most vulnerable countries. In addition, we agreed to suspend the debt in service suspension initiative until December 2021 and to implement the common framework on debt treatment. These initiatives have provided liquidity for low-income and vulnerable countries in a very difficult moment, while laying the foundation for a structural approach to address debt issues. Finally, the G20 launched an independent review of the capital adequacy framework of multilateral development banks, MDBs. We expect the review to improve our understanding of the various MDBs' capital adequacy frameworks and to see whether there is further room in their balance sheet to assist emerging economies, as well as low-income countries. Enabling future generations to handle shocks and reducing the world's vulnerability to future pandemics, alongside immediate and emergency interventions, has been a second key area of our presidency. The G20 has focused on strengthening pandemic preparedness, prevention, and response, and on improving international governance and coordination between global health and finance policymakers. Our ambition is to launch a structural coordination arrangement between finance and health ministries, thus enhancing cooperation and policy coherence among key stakeholders, while solving the problem of insufficient and fragmented financing for pandemic preparedness. Mobilizing all efforts for the green transition has been a third key area of engagement this year. The Italian G20 presidency has notably put green issue at the center of the G20 agenda, as a cross-country item. At our last ministerial meeting, we reached the consensus to coordinate efforts to tackle climate change and environmental degradation, and to promote transitions towards greener economies. This commitment to international coordination is a message of critical importance, especially as we head towards the COP26 in 2 weeks. Our presidency successfully re-established the Sustainable Finance Working Group, creating a permanent forum to discuss the climate and sustainability issue within the G20 finance track. A multi-year G20 roadmap for sustainable finance prepared by the working group was endorsed at the last ministerial meeting. This roadmap foresees a structured cooperation among all relevant G20 work streams, and it will act as a cornerstone for future G20 action across all the components of the green agenda. Advancing the infrastructure agenda. We also brought forward the agenda towards quality and sustainable infrastructure. We put maintenance among the infrastructure priority for 2021, with endorsement of the policy agenda on infrastructure maintenance, recognizing how adequate planning, funding, and resilience along the entire life of existing assets is critical and, for many countries, an urgent priority. We promoted a G20 discussion on sustainable infrastructure by hosting the first edition of the 2021 G20 Infrastructure Investors Dialogue on financing sustainable infrastructure for the recovery. Food security, nutrition, and food system have also been very high in our G20 presidency. The world is not on track to achieve zero hunger, as foreseen by the 2030 SDG agenda. Transforming food systems will require some $300-350 billion per year for the next decade. We need public development banks, PDBs, to be fully involved in the pursuit of a more sustainable agriculture. The G20 Matera Declaration recognizes the critical role of PDBs and welcomes the establishment of a working group on financing sustainable food systems, coordinated by the International Fund for Agricultural Development, IFAD. Today, as a follow-up to that and grounded on the new coalition of partners, we also welcome the creation of a platform for sustainable food systems, connecting IFAD and PDBs to bring this agenda forward. The linkages between the G20 agenda and the Financing Common Initiative are quite evident. The role of PDBs was acknowledged in the latest G20 Finance Minister and Central Bank Governors Communique, adopted in Washington a few days ago. This link is set to be maintained in the future. As the Financing Common Coalition has been asked to report on its progress to ministers and governors in 2022. Financing needs are huge. We need resources to change a new growth paradigm of our economies. The entire development bank community must be part of the collective effort toward a better and more resilient development. Public development banks are diverse, but they share a mission. They play a crucial role in providing finance and offering technical support, in setting the standards, in providing incentives, and in creating missing markets, including in local currency. There is room for strengthening synergies and coordination among PDBs, and for leveraging their network to engage in joint operation and to develop innovative finance instruments. The Financing Common Summit, which is due to become an annual event, has a crucial role to play in this regard. Thank you very much.